In section 3 of the course, we'll take a look at how to create common gameplay elements. Specifically, we'll look at how to create a high score, how to establish win and loss conditions within the game based on that score, and we'll also see occlusion culling to see how we can improve the performance of our game. In this video, we're going to create a collectible object, and in doing that, we're going to work with triggers and events to respond to player movement. In this video, I want to tackle the challenge of creating some basic gameplay elements that pretty much every kind of game is going to need. In nearly every kind of game, the player is going to have to move around and maybe collect things, or touch things, or come into contact with things, and we need to be able to know about that when those conflicts happen, when the player comes into contact with something. And in this scene here that you can see in front of us, which is basically the blacksmith scene, you can see we have a pretty much a kind of medieval blacksmith village with a variety of different buildings and constructions around. And at the center of the scene, we have this shield element here. I'm just going to select the shield. This shield is constantly spinning around, and it's a kind of object that the player can collect. If I press play on the toolbar here, I can move the character around in first-person mode by using the W, A, S, and D keys on the keyboard to control the player character here, and I can climb these steps here to move to this element. Now I want to be able to run through this and to collect the element and for the element to disappear. Now to do this I need to detect when the collision between the player and this collectible object happens. And this is a basic scripting task that pretty much every kind of game is going to need. And in this video, I want to show you how we can implement this. By selecting the shield element here, or the shield collectible object, you can see that it has the auto move and rotate script attached. And this script is part of the utilities package, and really this is responsible for spinning the object around. You can easily import this script into your project by simply choosing Assets, Import Package, and then choosing Utility. And then that will give you access to the auto move and rotate script. In addition to the rotation script, you can see I also have a collider component attached to this object. This is a box collider, and I've marked this as is trigger. It is surrounding the object, and it will allow us to detect when the player comes into contact with the object, and so we know when the player is going to collect it. So that's pretty good, but still we need to identify when the collision with the player happens and to respond to that. Now to do this, I'm going to create a completely new script file. So I'm going to move down here to the project panel inside the scripts folder, and I'm going to right click and choose create, and then choose C# script from the context menu. And I'm simply going to call this collect object and press enter on the keyboard. Now I'm going to drag and drop that onto our power-up object, which is the collection shield object, to attach that script as a component to the object. And let's open that inside MonoDevelop here. So I'm going to double-click the script file to open that inside MonoDevelop. Now to determine when the player comes into contact with objects, I'm just going to delete all of these here. We need to respond to the OnTriggerEnter function. So I'm going to add a new event here, which is going to be OnTriggerEnter. And we need to provide an argument which effectively represents the object that has entered the trigger. So this script file is attached to the power-up object. The other argument simply represents the player that has entered the trigger. Now when the player enters the trigger, it's still possible for any kind of object to enter the trigger. For example, we could have another physical object in the level, such as an NPC character, which could potentially come into contact with this collectible object. Now, we don't want NPC characters being able to collect this power-up. It's the kind of thing that only the player can collect. And in that case, we need to actually verify what this object is that has collided with the power-up, and to validate it to make sure that the object that has entered is the player object, and in that case, we want to kind of deactivate the collectible. So here I need to validate what is this object, and to do that I'm going to be checking the tag of the object. So I'm simply going to say if the object compare tag is the player tag, that is, if the object that has entered this collider is not the player character, notice the exclamation mark to indicate the inversion, that is the not operator. So if this is not the player character, then simply exit the function. We don't need to process this function anymore at all. We've identified that this is not the player character, so simply exit the function. But if we get to this line down here beneath this return statement, that means that the object that has collided with this object is indeed the player character. Now, in the case of our collectible object in this scene, all I want to do is simply to deactivate the object. But in many other cases, there might be other things that I want to do as well. And to kind of customize the functionality that happens, I can add a Unity event. Now, to do that, I need to go back up to the top of the source file here and choose and add additional namespaces. So in this case here, I need to add the Unity engine and I need to add Unity events here. So I'm going to choose Unity engine dot, and we have events. And I also want to add the event system. So again, Unity engine and dot event systems like so. And then I can add a new event object to the top of this file by choosing public Unity event. And I can say on trigger, not enter, but on trigger near. So I can choose when we get inside the trigger, or rather on trigger inside when the player gets inside the trigger. I can invoke this event down here inside this function. So I can use onTriggerInside.invoke, and that will activate the event when the player enters the trigger. I'm going to press Command S on the keyboard to save these changes and return back to Unity here. So back to the Unity editor, the code will compile. And on top of this object here now, you can see we have this event onTriggerInside to indicate what do we want to do when the player enters the trigger. So we can actually customize the functionality of this object directly from the object inspector. So on the onTriggerInside event, I'm going to click the plus icon to respond to this. And here we get to specify what do we want to do. Well, in this case, I want to grab my powerUp object. I'm going to be working with this object here. What do I want to do to that object? And we can specify in here. In this case, I want to select the game object and make it invisible, or rather to deactivate the object to indicate that we have collected it. Now, again, it appears outside the recording window, but there is an option here that says set active. I'm going to choose set active here. You can see this specified here. And now we have this checkbox to indicate what do we want to set the active status to. With the tick enabled, that means that the object should be activated. With the tick outside, it means the object should be deactivated, which is the one that we want in this case. This simply means that when the player enters the box collider, enters this trigger object, it's going to be deactivated and it's going to hide. Let's test this code out. I'm going to press play on the toolbar here and then move my character around in first person mode. And as I approach the shield and walk over it, again, bam, the object is being collected. Oh, but notice again here, notice that the object did not disappear. So let's see why this is the case. The reason for this is because if I select the player object, that is the first person controller object here, you'll see that the tag is currently specified as untagged. And when we took a look at our code and the object entered the collider, we wanted to make sure that the object that entered the collider had the player tag. So I'm going to grab the player tag and change this from untagged to player here to specify that this has the player tag. Press play on the toolbar again to try it out this time. And now if I run through the collider, let's just run through this object. And again, bam, the object has now disappeared because we've entered the collider. The player character has the player tag. And now the object disappears because we specified inside the object inspector here for our collectible, we specified what we wanted to happen. Of course, I could add more actions to this by clicking on the plus icon. This is simply the power of Unity events and how we get to customize what happens directly inside the inspector. So again, this combination of OnTriggerEnter and Unity events is a really powerful combination.